where you've gone. There's no denying you'll feel blue, you'll feel sad, you'll miss the bestest pal that you've ever had. Well, there'll come a time, now don't forget it, there'll come a time when you'll regret it. Someday when you grow lonely, your heart will break like mine and you'll want me only. After you've gone, after you've gone away.
How many people do you know? How many people?
I don't know anybody.
Come on, 500, 1,000?
I'd like to know the girl in the blue dress. She keeps looking at me.
All the people that I know, every last person, all the people that I know, not one. I don't even think that there is an exception to this. Not one is truly happy. Never mind truly happy. I don't even think that they're reasonably happy.
Yeah, well, I would be happy if I could find somebody to introduce me. I swear, she keeps looking. I think I should go over there.
In 20 years, I don't even think the word happy is going to be in the dictionary.
I don't believe this. I think she's coming. She's coming over here.
May I join you?
Yes, please. My name's Arthur, and this is Mel.
You're Melvin. I know. My name is Marilyn. I asked the bartender if she knew you. Do you think I'm too bold?
Are you happy?
I think you're a bit drunk.
This is the first time I've seen you here.
Oh, really? Answer the question. If you think about the progress of your whole life, right? Think about that. And now, tell me if you think that you're a reasonably happy person.
My life? My life is a shambles.
Well, you see? Well, don't worry about it. You're no different from anybody else.
Where do you live?
In the 50s. At least people were happy then.
What's your address?
Thanks for the lift.
Is it because of your divorce? The bartender said you were divorced. I don't think I've ever met anyone so completely disinterested in me.
Oh, would you like me to call you? Just let me, give me your telephone number.
Really?
Sure, give me your number and I'll give you a call in a couple of weeks. We could talk together on the phone a couple of times and then... You know, we see if we like each other, and then maybe we could go out.
Are you always this cautious?
Cautious? This isn't cautious. Cautious is not even having this conversation.
You've obviously been hurt.
Haven't you been hurt?
Yes. Yes, I have. What was her name?
Cynthia. I mean, people got to stop being so stupid. I mean, goddammit, you see this beautiful swimming pool and you jump in and break your neck because there's no water inside. How many times are you going to keep jumping into the swimming pool and breaking your neck?
I don't know.
I mean, not that I've got anything against swimming. Just that I'd like to put my toe into the pool and see if it gets wet.
You didn't get my number.
Oh, yeah, give it to me. I'll remember.
739-1503.
I've got it. I got it.
What is it?
I'm a school teacher. I can remember a couple of numbers, you know.
Tell me, please.
It's 579.
Just forget it.
6475.
He's not here.
Where is he?
I don't know.
So what else is new?
Hello. hell with it.
To hell with what?
What's the difference? What the hell with it anyways?
What were you doing over there?
Screaming.
Come on.
Well, you don't think old people like to scream? At least in their institution, they get recess. My institution? Gotta sneak up.
What is it with this institution crap? You're trying to make me feel guilty? You're only gonna be there one more week.
What do you mean, one more week?
I signed the lease, I rented a truck, we're moving in 1 week.
I never said yes.
You said if I got a bigger place, it would be a good idea.
I said it might not be a bad idea. That's not the same as saying it's a good idea.
I showed you the Polaroid, for God's sake. You said the house was nice.
I said the picture was nice. An appreciation of photography is not the same thing as saying yes to moving in.
Say yes, or I'm going to push you in front of a car.
I don't know. It don't feel right. It's unnatural.
What is unnatural about living with your own son?
Well, why do you want it so bad?
I want us to be together.
Aha. Now I know what's troubling me. Mm-hmm. Sounds like a proposal. You're all finished with women. You want to marry your father.
Would you cut it out?
Melvin, it's not altogether a joke. Look, you got a big hole in your life. You want to use me to help fill it up. What are we going to do in the house? Who's going to cook, wash the dishes? I was divorced once already. I don't want to go through it again.
All right, if the answer is no, the answer is no. I'll just get out of the lease, all right?
Did I say the answer was no?
Gonna take a sentimental journey. Gonna set my heart at ease. I'm gonna take a sentimental journey to renew old memories. I never thought I could be so yearning. Why did I decide to roam? I'm gonna take a sentimental journey. Sentimental journey home.
Melvin! 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 Hey, you wait a minute. Tell the man inside his bride is here. Do me a favor, just tell him.
You please see.
Pa! Pa, I didn't know you'd arrive. Did you see the neighborhood? Isn't it great? It's just like the old days. There's Greeks, Italians, there's Portuguese, there's Jamaicans, Koreans. Come on, come on, Pa. You are not going to believe this. It is amazing. Come here. Look, Pa.
The same radiator that we used to have. And look. Look at that archway.
Do you remember?
No.
Pa?
Wait till you see this.
Ta-da! Almost exactly the same cupboard. Look at this, Pa. It's the same weeds that we had on Esplanade. Amazing, huh? And look! Look, just like the old place. The fence is missing. Huh? Huh?
Well, would you ride with me in a pickup truck? Baby, try all out for the afternoon.
Oh, well, the we could pipes are broke.
Can you turn it off?
The pipes are broke?
You turn it off? Yeah, listen, pas de musique, okay? I told you.
Broken pipes, you're right. Does remind me of the old house.
It was supposed to be fixed this morning.
Bonjour.
Je vais vous présenter mon père, Sir Harvey Rosenblum. This is our landlady, Miss La Riviere. Pa, let's go look at the rest of the house, okay?
How'd you break it?
What do you mean, break it? I'm fixing it.
You're French?
Yes.
Since when do French people know about fixing pipes?
Pa!
Qu'est-ce que vous voulez dire? Vous pensez qu'on n'est pas capable de réparer des choses?
He's blagging, okay? C'est une joke. Pa, come on, I'm gonna show you the bedrooms.
So you're the landlady. Tell me, how old are you?
That's enough, Pa.
What is this?
All right, if it's a big secret, I don't want to know.
I'm 27.
Pa, time to choose your bedroom.
Just tell me the truth. Now, is this your father's house or is this your house?
This house is mine. I bought it with my money. My father is dead.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear it. May you rest in peace. Was he a young man when he died?
Okay, fine. Look, Pa, would you do me a favor, please, and let Miss La Riviere fix the sink?
Look, we're just having a nice little conversation. Look, this is a landlady-tenant relationship here. In about a year, we'll be either figuring out a way to kill each other or we'll be good friends. Now, I'll make us all a nice cup of tea. Got a kettle? Has this house got a kettle?
Go. Just... Okay, careful.
It takes out the voice from the song, so you can sing with the music. Listen. How about an evening ride when it's warm outside? We could stop and gaze up at the stars. It is called a vocal eliminator.
Too bad it don't eliminate the music also. Hey, both you guys come have a cup of tea.
No, merci.
Whose table is that? Is that your table?
No.
No, it's my table, so put the table down, come and have a cup of tea. Tomorrow will be different, but unfortunately today we got no lemon.
You want lemon? I have upstairs.
You live upstairs?
Yes.
What are you doing?
What does it look like I'm doing? I'm trying to move us in.
Melvin, there's an old Jewish expression. You should enjoy your first day in your new house, because whatever happens on that day is the sample for all the days to follow.
Jackie!
Don't let him in. He's drunk.
He's gonna break the window.
Just turn around. Don't pay him any attention. Maybe he'll go away. If not, we'll call the police. So here we all are having a nice quiet cup of tea without lemon, wondering if it's going to rain tomorrow afternoon. I don't want to look around. Did he go away?
No. But I think he's going to break something.
What's going on? Walter!
You know this guy?
Oh, he's drunk.
What?
Your key. You lost your key.
Let's go.
Sit him down before he falls down.
Walter, je te présente Harvey et son fils Melvin et
Joe.
Denis.
You better sit down.
Let's go.
Hey!
Better go up there, eh?
My hero. Don't be stupid. Call the police.
No!
I think he killed her. No. I think it's okay now.
Who knows?
Well, at least they're not fighting anymore.
Crazy Goyim's.
Don't talk like that.
Why not?
Because it's racist. Jewish people don't fight?
With their mouths, they fight with words. They don't fight with furniture. It's too expensive.
Oh, terrific. First, you insult Gentiles, then Jews. I hate it when you talk like that.
So don't listen. Go to bed.
Remember that old Jewish saying about whatever happens on the first day of a new house?
Don't worry, I made it up. Mm-hmm.
How's a person supposed to grow up in a place like this, huh?
It's all wrong.
Do you remember how happy we were?
You were happy. You were too young to know any better.
Thank you.
Pa? Pa? I don't believe it. When did you do all this?
Couldn't sleep.
Why didn't you wait for me? We're supposed to do this together.
No problem. We'll put everything back in the boxes and we'll take them out again.
Hey, okay. Pa, relax, okay? What's the matter with you? Are you feeling all right?
The only thing that feels all right is my teeth. It's because they're false. Everything else hurts like hell.
Well, when are you going to see the doctor?
Who knows? He only calls me when he needs money. The physiotherapist is coming tomorrow, the Schwarzer.
Don't use that word.
Why not? Schwarz means black. What is she, purple?
Oh. She has a name. If she were Jewish, she wouldn't say, the Jew is coming. Her name is Evangeline. Use it.
Who could use a name like that? Huh? Why are you getting so upset?
Because it hurts, okay? After everything they've been through, Jewish people should know better.
What's going on here? I'm making you breakfast. You're giving me a lecture. I'm not one of your students. Boychi, how long do you think this marriage will last?
Oh. Bonjour.
Bonjour.
Comment va ton père?
Ça va bien.
I'm still alive.
I'm sorry about yesterday. I was drunk.
We noticed.
I'm stupid when I'm drunk. Why doesn't she kick me out?
Probably because she'd break her foot.
Well, I suppose you're here to finish fixing the sink.
I come back later. But now I need my vocal eliminator.
Your what?
A music box. You're a singer.
Oh, I wish I was.
I'm a bouncer at a nightclub.
Listen, mister, I'll tell you straight out, I don't like people who fight. I figure sooner or later they're gonna hit me.
I apologized for yesterday.
Oh, I'm glad that after you hit somebody, you apologize. Don't feel so worried now.
Don't forget the sink. Let's not have anything to do with them.
He's crazy. She's not so bad.
What's this?
Come on, you can figure it out. What's it look like?
Ha. You made me a sandwich.
What happened to the lunch pail I bought you?
That was 30 years ago.
Don't shake your head at me like that. Reminds me of your mother. Enough to ruin my old day.
That's Mary. She used to be married to him. He's Vince. But she doesn't remember him because she lost her memory. She married this terrible man called Reginald Love, and they adopted a baby, even though she was already married and had four children. Now, 17 years later, one of her daughters, Cheryl, met her stepbrother without realizing it, and they fell in love. So, in other words, Mary's son and her daughter are having an affair. So, Melvin.
Yeah, Ma?
How do you like living with your father? Oh, wait a minute, look. That's Donna and Michael. They got married Tuesday.
It's the first day of the rest of our lives.
And just what are we gonna do for the rest of our lives, hmm?
Make love.
Hello.
Jerry, look who's here. Melvin came for a visit, and Don and Michael got back from their honeymoon.
Melvin, how's it going at the school?
Oh, good. Thank you very much.
I thought you were playing tennis.
Yeah, I'm playing tennis, but I was jogging, and now I got to take a shower first. Why don't you come on Saturday? On Saturday, I don't do anything.
Don't you play football on Saturdays?
Monday.
Look, look, I want you to see this part.
To tell you the truth, for 30 years, it wasn't such a bad deal. But then I made a big mistake.
What did you do?
I took her to a tennis game on her birthday. She fell in love with one of the players. She was 59 years old.
Oh, you're joking.
Yeah, some joke. He was 63. It was a game for golden ages.
Your wife was not faithful?
Come on, Rose. She wouldn't do a thing like that. She's Jewish.
You're telling me? Jewish people are not Not faithful.
Jewish people who do things like that are not Jewish. They start acting foolish like that, they become Gentiles. Don't take that personal.
Why should I take it personal?
Look, I don't like Jacqueline. Can I call you Jackie?
Okay. But if your wife was not faithful, what was wrong?
They did other things together.
What other things?
They played horseshoes together, they played ping pong together, they played bowling.
That was some big affair.
My arthritis, what kind of games can I play? Poker. So I got a divorce. She said she still loved me, but I left anyway.
How could you do that? After 30 years?
A woman's place is beside her husband, not running around some bowling alley.
That's why I won't get married, like my sisters.
You have sisters? Where are they?
I have four sisters. They are in the kitchen.
You're kidding. What kitchen?
Each one has her kitchen, and that's where they stay. With their babies. They have husbands who think the same way as you.
They live in Montreal?
No, up north. Lake Saint-Jean.
In the kitchen?
Yeah.
What about that elephant upstairs? You won't get married?
Walter? I will never marry Walter.
Why not? If you're going to fight so much, you might as well be married.
I want him to move out. I'm going to tell him tonight when I see him at work.
Oh, you work in the same place?
No. He's a bouncer. I teach dancing. His club is next door of the school. That's how we met. What's wrong? It hurts you?
No, it's nothing. Why are you sending him away?
Hey, come on. I have no furniture left.
What did you like about him in the first place?
He protects me.
You need protection?
Doesn't everybody?
I can't get over you two. She was asking about you earlier, Rick, in a way that made me extremely jealous.
I wasn't sure you were the same. Let's see the last time we met.
Was La Bella Roa.
How nice you remembered. But of course that was the day the Germans marched into Paris.
Not an easy day to forget. I remember every detail. The Germans wore gray, you wore blue.
What are you doing up? Didn't get enough TV at your mother's?
This is not TV. It's a movie.
Looks like TV to me. What's wrong with the color?
This is before color. This is before selfishness. Ingrid Bergman gives up her love. Humphrey Bogart gives up his freedom. Even the rotten chief of police gives up his career.
Sorry I asked. Maybe we better do something.
Don't worry about it. For them, this is foreplay.
Yeah, but maybe this time it's different. Go see if she's all right.
Are you kidding? No way am I going up there.
Just ring the bell, see if she's okay. Look, for God's sake, I'm gonna call the cops. All right, I'm gonna go myself.
All right, all right.
You just go to hell, okay?
Miss LaRiviere, are you okay? Are you all right?
I'm okay. He would never hurt me. He just breaks the chairs.
Uh-huh.
Poor Walter.
Poor Walter? The guy's a bouncer. He's used to it. You seem to get off on it. What about people who want peace and quiet?
Hey, just a minute.
You're right. I'm sorry.
Huh? Enough is enough. Well,
damn!
Mon Dieu, are you okay?
I'm okay. Are you okay?
Walter!
You want me to call, please?
No. Go to bed. It's all right.
What? It's nothing, don't worry about it. I think everything will be all right.
What do you mean, what happened?
What happened? Everything's okay, don't worry, okay? He said he'd never hurt you.
He ran out of chairs.
Don't joke about it. Your eye looks terrible.
He didn't mean nothing. He just pushed me aside and I went flying.
Who's there?
It's Miss LaRiviere, Pa.
Jacqueline.
Jackie?
Yes?
You all right?
Yes.
What happened?
I'm sorry.
What's going on?
It's okay, Pa. Just go to sleep, okay? Now, this is probably none of my business, but how can you be attracted to someone who's so violent?
So, she's all right?
I suppose so. Move over.
There's no way you're getting into this bed.
Come on. Where am I going to sleep?
Go sleep on a couch or something.
We don't own a couch. Move over.
I knew this would happen sooner.
Oh, you want me to help you move your
legs? Don't touch me, all right? You just stay on your own side of the bed.
You know what?
What now?
I think this idea of sensitivity is a myth. I think underneath every one of them is cold and unfeeling.
Who? Gentiles?
Women.
I don't approve of sexual discrimination.
First impression can really mind. She took one look at the man and said he was just not her kind of first impression.
Who are you? My name is Jacqueline. I'm a visitor.
Where's the whole man?
He's waiting for you in bed.
Don't let her in here. Tell her I died my sleep.
Where is his son?
Gone to work.
Let me see that face. A man did this?
Yes.
And you let him do it?
He didn't give me no choice.
You always got a choice. You got to know to take their power and make it yours. Where does it hurt?
You don't think I'm stupid enough to answer. I tell you where it hurts is exactly where you squeeze.
Where?
Oh!
Come on. It's hurt, but it don't hurt that much.
You, it don't hurt that much. What are you doing?
Acupressure. I do it with my thumbs.
Oh, it's just what I need. Black voodoo.
What you want?
Is Jacqueline here?
Your friend?
Yeah.
Don't let him in!
Let me by. I want to talk to her.
I don't want to hurt you. Beside, our water, you walk out the door while you can. You look too big for me to carry.
Who are you?
That don't matter, mister. I'm asking you to leave.
Listen, if you don't go now, I'm calling the police.
That's okay. Walter was just leaving. Goodbye, Walter.
I go nowhere without you.
Come on, big boy. Do you feel pain? Give me your hand. Does that feel better? Come on, I'll help you to the door. That's it. No more anger.
Don't get confused. You're supposed to take away pain.
You know what that big idiot did when we got to the door? He asked me my phone number.
What happened? Did something burn?
You must be a detective.
Oh, you burnt a pot, eh?
Two pots. One with soup. I didn't think you could burn soup. And while I was cleaning it, the other stupid pot decided to burn. What are you doing here?
I live here.
Well, could have chosen a better time to come back.
I'm sorry.
J'ai jamais eu de problème comme ça, me calme de ville. It's because I am in the kitchen.
Oh, well, you don't have to cook or anything to show your gratitude. Don't force yourself to act out some ridiculous female stereotype.
I forgot you were a teacher.
Actually, I'm exactly the same way with women. I mean, most of the time I'm me, whatever that happens to be. Call it Mel. But then when you're around, then I have to act like a man, whatever that is.
Is there going to be an exam on this?
Where's my father?
He's asleep. The physiotherapist got him tired.
Oh, well, you don't have to stick around to look after my father or anything, but thank you very much.
What about the door?
What door?
My door. It's still broken. Walter could come back.
You think he's going to come back?
No. I'm nervous, okay? When something happens, I'm more used to a big family, not an empty house.
Were you in love with Walter?
He's like a brother.
Oh, really? Yeah, it's funny. It really didn't seem like a brother-sister relationship from down here.
What do you mean?
Oh, nothing.
You're disapproving with me.
How can you love somebody who beats you up?
I'm here because of your father, okay? Not you. I recognize the look on your face.
What look?
You don't know what look?
No.
I'm going to tell you. You think about making love to me all the time. That's why you talk so much.
I always talk a lot.
And at the same time, you don't respect me. Don't be so nervous. I would never make love to a judge.
Male and female sex hormones are found in both sexes. And it's a relative amount of these hormones, androgens in male and progesterone and estrogen in females, that determines primary and secondary sex characteristics. In other words, the line between males and females is not as sharply drawn as some people may think. Am I partly a woman as well as a man?
I've often wondered about you, sir.
Now, please review for me what you've been discussing.
Yeah, well, that's your, here it is.
Yeah.
Oh, God. Ma?
Oh, no.
Thank you.
Why do I let myself worry? Wondering what in the world did I do? Oh, crazy for thinking that my love could hold you. I'm crazy for trying for crying, and I'm crazy for loving you.
Pa, hi. Are you all right?
Yeah.
You know what happened?
What?
Jerry died.
Your mother's Jerry?
Yeah.
So bad.
How can you laugh at someone who died, even if he did take your wife away?
He didn't take her away. I send her away. Anyway, that's how I'm laughing. I'm laughing because he always used to tell me that I'd go to an early grave because I didn't get any exercise. How'd that happen?
He was doing push-ups.
He must. How's your mother?
She's all right. She was watching television, talking to him at the same time, and she didn't realize he was dead until after the show was over. Ask Marilyn a law? Sorry, I must have the wrong number. Sorry.
Lech v'ashem yiyeh imach, go thy way, and may God be with thee. Amen.
Amen.
Come on, Mom.
No.
What?
Just a minute.
Okay.
Someday when you grow lonely, your heart will break like
What's wrong?
I'm gonna die.
What? What are you talking about? What happened? Are you okay? Did you call a doctor?
Please don't get excited. It's not gonna happen right away. But one of these days, it'll happen.
Are you crazy? How can you do that to me? What's happening to you?
Nothing's happening. I'm waiting. Then I'm gonna die, and that's all. You're making me dizzy.
Well, I don't understand. You know, everybody's gonna die. I'm gonna die. So why are you so depressed?
Well, so I should be less depressed because you're gonna die too. Where are all the children? Hmm? What do? They hide them someplace?
It's very early in the morning.
You know something? You're pretty stupid.
Why am I stupid?
Because at least I was smart enough to have a child before I got divorced. Not a normal child, but at least a child. What do you got to show?
Nothing.
What do you think they talked about all day in the old people's home? Hmm? Business? Politics? Grandchildren. That's all they talked about. Grandchildren.
Hold on a minute. You want grandchildren?
I want to go home. Don't stand there. Give me a push.
Hello, is Marilyn there? Marilyn? No, I just never thought I'd get your number. It's me. It's Mel. Do you remember me? A few weeks ago at Woody's? Yeah. How are you?
Do I look?
You look nice.
Just nice?
An angel from heaven. Are you sure your grandmother wasn't Jewish?
Pa, go. Be careful, though, okay? Mm.
Go. Not bad.
Yeah.
A little bumpy, but not bad.
Bumpy? Where? Pa? Pa? Where is it bumpy?
Never mind. It's all right. This the car? I don't want to look at her. She reminds me of pain.
Oh, she looks so beautiful.
I'm
sorry.
What's the matter?
Hello?
Now all the furniture can relax. He breaks something, she'll break his neck. He'll get what's coming to him.
Are you all right to drive?
No, he won't.
God knows what he's doing.
He won't what?
Won't get what's coming to him.
What do you mean?
What?
I think I'm pregnant. So don't try to tell me God knows what he's doing.
It's better than the first bottle, but it's not as good as the second.
Do you always drink this much?
Come on now, I've been drunk in my life precisely 4 times, exactly.
And I've been lucky enough to be with you for at least two.
Two, yeah, mm. All right, congratulations.
Thank you very much. The question is, What am I doing here?
This is true. Well, this is step two. Step one was when we spoke together on the telephone. Mm-hmm. And step two is getting completely smashed together. Mm-hmm. And step, well, I got an idea. Why don't we skip three and just go straight to your place?
Tell me about Cynthia.
Yeah, about Cynthia.
Well, I remember names, like you remember phone numbers.
Numbers, oh, well, Cynthia loved numbers. Boy, she had my number. Now I got her number.
What do you mean?
The full moon, dramatic music. And Cynthia said, our taxes will go down if we get married.
You're kidding.
I proposed. Her accountant said yes.
You were in love with her.
What are we doing here?
This is where I picked you up.
No, see, this is my place. We can't go to my place. My place is my father's place. We got to go to your place.
You know, some people get drunk when they have to do things that they don't want to do. Good night, Melvin.
You don't want to go to your place?
No.
You want me to get out here?
Yes.
Okay, I'll get out here.
Bring your leg. No, no. Come on.
Hey.
Which one is your place?
Oh.
Your father, I suppose. I'm beginning to see what's going on.
What's going on?
Bastard.
What are the two of you doing here?
He's all yours, lady, and you're welcome to him.
Why don't you take him downstairs?
What for? I just brought him upstairs.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh!
Whoa, so this is your little nest. It's very nice, very... It's very feminine. There's lots of estrogen and progesterone all over the place.
Shut up and sit down.
I'm perfectly okay. What are you doing?
Phoning your father.
That's a very good idea. It'll take him a long time. 10 minutes to get out of bed. 5 minutes for the left foot. 5 minutes for the right foot.
That's no funny.
I know. Wait a minute. This is you're the one. You're the one who should be sitting down here, because we have to look after you.
Don't be ridiculous. I can look after myself.
This is really a wonderful, wonderful place. Ah. Crazy. I'm crazy for feeling so lonely. Crazy.
Come on.
I'm crazy for feeling so... Ooh. Where are we going?
To bed.
Oh, well, I want you to know that you've made absolutely the right decision. I've thought a lot about this. I've considered it very carefully. And I realized that after checking out all those facts, I realized that even though there may be no water in the pool, I wouldn't have gone swimming with Marilyn if I didn't want to go swimming with you. You're right. See, it's very silly. There's a powerful, powerful sexual attraction. Wait, there's one other thing I wanted to tell you. I'm no longer a judge. I've retired. Where'd you go?
It's not the pale moon that excites me, that thrills and delights me. Oh no, it's just the nearness of you. Isn't your sweet conversation that brings this sensation? Oh no, it's just the nearness of you. When you're in my arms and I feel you so close to me, all my wildest dreams come true.
I have a confession to make. I don't remember what happened last night.
Oh, I see.
I've been celibate for a long time, and I finally have sex. And it's ironic, I don't even remember. I'm just as stupid and insensitive as everybody else.
Mel.
I'm sorry it happened, especially with you.
Oh?
No, it's just that I thought that if ever I was lucky enough that we would make love, that it would be unforgettable. Unforgettable.
That's enough. Nothing happened last night.
Nothing happened.
You're wearing your clothes, for God's sake.
Yeah, but that doesn't necessarily mean that nothing happened.
Nothing happened.
Well, that's a relief. Maybe we should have dinner one night. Would you like to have dinner one night?
No.
No?
No.
Well, when we kissed before, I thought that there was something happening between us.
All right. We can make love, but no relationship. No dinner.
You're kidding, right?
I won't go to dinner, but we can still make love.
Not with me.
Don't worry. I've been very careful.
I can't believe it. You're exactly the kind of person I've been trying to avoid.
Here comes the judge.
Safe sex? As if there was something safe about sex.
You know, when you were sleeping, you looked okay. I forgot what an idiot you are.
Oh, we can have sex, right? But no dinner.
No relationship.
I suppose you want me for my body, right?
I don't want you at all.
Well, I'm glad nothing happened last night.
So am I.
Good morning. This girl, Marilyn, must be really something.
What do you know about Marilyn?
Come on, how many times did I hear you calling all those wrong numbers? Is she Jewish?
No, she's black and male.
Very funny. You going to work?
Yes.
Do me a favor, would you ring Jackie's bell? Tell her I want to see her.
What do you want to talk to Jackie about?
What are you, the CIA? You have to know about every conversation?
How about dinner tonight?
I do not plan so far.
Good. It's settled then.
When I sold my business, I got a few $1,000s. Tell you the truth, I got more than a few $1,000s. And what did I do with it? I put it in the bank. And what's it do in the bank? Nothing.
So what's the problem?
Well, if it just sat in the bank, that would be one thing. But it also sits here, like an ulcer. Every day I think about it, sitting in the bank doing nothing, and it gives me a pain. So what can I do with it? Now, I'm already getting the old age pension. Mel, thank God, doesn't need the money. And to make matters worse, the bank keeps giving me interest.
I wish I had that problem.
Good. I want you to take some of it off my hands.
You want to loan me money?
No, not loan. I'm going to give it to you. Once you take it, it's your responsibility. I don't want to see it anymore.
You want to give me money?
Don't worry. You'll have no trouble getting rid of it. Believe me, babies are very good at spending money.
Harvey. Oh, you're a sneaky old man. I know you want to help, but there won't be any baby.
That's what I was afraid of.
I'm going to quit my job and become a singer. This is no time for a baby.
That's all right for you, but what about the person who's in there right now, huh? Maybe that person will grow up to be a scientist, a musician, a good gin rummy player. Doesn't he or she deserve a chance to be alive?
I'm sorry. I don't want this conversation. I'll give her a hand.
No, I don't want you lifting heavy things.
It's very nice of you to come with your car and help me move.
It's no trouble. I only work at night.
Oh, what kind of a job do you do at night?
I teach dancing.
Oh, dancing. I see. You know, I'm so mixed up with leaving the apartment that I didn't hear your name when you told me.
Jacqueline.
What kind of a name is that? Wait a minute. I think you have an accent.
Mom, she's not Jewish, okay?
Ask you if she was Jewish?
I'm French-Canadian.
See, that's all I wanted to know. My son thinks he can read my mind. Believe you me, if he could do that, he'd be plenty surprised.
You have secrets, Mom?
Well, I'm not dead yet. If you don't have some secrets, you might as well be dead. There's this woman, Barbara something. She's 93. Everyone thinks she's a nice old lady, but you know what she does? She's a drug dealer. Oh, I'm not telling a lie. I saw that on TV. So he hid the gun in the bottom drawer along with his socks and his underwear. And then the granddaughter, the one that was pregnant, you know, she was putting away the laundry, and she opened the drawer, and when she saw the gun, she saw the gun.
Ma.
What? Where was I? What was I saying?
Ma, don't judge the place till you look inside, okay?
I'm not judging. Who's judging? This is where your father used to stay?
Yeah.
He liked it here?
Oh, yeah, he liked the fact that there was a school across the street. Look, Ma, I'm going to level with you, okay? He hated it. If you don't like it, then I'll just find you someplace else, that's all.
Looks like a hospital.
I know, so what are we doing here? Why don't we just keep your apartment?
Because I can't stand to live alone. Oh, my cactus. Will you go get my cactus?
How you feeling?
Terrible. How else?
Look, Pa, I want to talk to you about something.
Don't bother. The answer's no.
How can the answer be no? You haven't even heard the question.
I know the question. I'm not dumb. I don't even want to discuss it.
Pa. Do you remember how you felt?
Look, I mean it. I mean it. That's it. That's enough. She's not coming here, and that's the end.
Pa, come on. Wait a minute. I'm not asking you to agree to anything. I just want to talk about it.
There's nothing to talk about. Now, she'll learn what it's like to be alone. Let her suffer the way I suffered. And you, please, just leave me alone. Get out of my room.
I never thought that you'd be so vengeful.
You think I didn't know this would happen? I know how your head works. You want your family, your mommy, your daddy.
Oh, don't be ridiculous.
Of course it's ridiculous. What about Cynthia? You want to bring Cynthia here, too?
Come on, that is just silly.
Who's silly? Am I going backwards? Maybe you think your life isn't long enough as it is, but mine, thank God, is almost over. Sooner than you'd think.
Is it obvious that I'm Jewish?
I figured you would.
Does it surprise you to see a Jewish person like me in a place like this?
Why should it? We often get Jewish people in here.
Ought to be ashamed of themselves. Give me another schnapps.
Hey, give me a beer here, huh?
I can't hear you.
Just pay attention. Listen to me. Okay.
Where are you? What?
You're not in charge of the boat.
A boat?
You're not the captain of the boat, and I'm not the captain of the boat. The master of the universe, the almighty.
Harvey, I'm late for work. Why can't we...
Goodbye. Bounce. How's Evangeline? No fighting?
I just do what she tells me.
Wait a minute. Doesn't Jackie work next door?
No, not here.
She says she worked next door teaching dance.
No, it used to be, but they moved.
Well, let me in. I want to buy a schnapps.
No, not here.
Excuse me, mister. Where are you going? I'm next in line.
Oh, I'm sorry, sir. Go ahead.
No. Go in. He can't go.
What do you mean? Why not?
Go in. None of your business. Get inside.
Come on, let him in.
What's going on?
What is your policy regarding handicapped people?
What do you mean? No problem.
That's what I thought.
Right this way, sir. Come on.
Now you should go to sleep.
Just don't bother me.
Why did you go to a place like that?
I'm glad I went, and I'm glad I saw what I saw.
Well, what were you crying about? Any woman that works at a place like that is just not worth getting upset about.
Now, look who's talking about being tolerant. Anyways, I wasn't crying for her. Why should I cry for her? If she wants to take off her clothes in front of strangers, it's her business.
What were you crying about?
I was crying for Rose.
What?
I was crying for Rose.
Ma? You're crying about Ma? What do you mean you're crying about Ma?
Stop yelling. I got a headache.
Well, I don't know what you're talking about.
If you want to know, I'll tell you. In my whole life, until tonight, Rose was the only woman I ever saw like that, without clothes. So what can I tell you? It reminded me of my honeymoon.
Well, you don't have to talk about it.
She took off her dress. She was so ashamed. She started crying. She couldn't stop. Well, I felt sorry for her, so I guess there were tears in my eyes, too. And when she saw that, she started laughing. It's the way she was. If I did one thing, she did the opposite.
Is there anything that I can do to make you happy?
You want to make me happy? Go to bed.
In bloom, there were stars in the skies, except for the few that were there in your eyes.
Hi.
You really think this is a good time to talk?
Walter told me you were at the club.
Well, actually, there isn't much to talk about, is there?
You can say what you want in front of your mother. I'm not ashamed of what I do.
Oh, really? Why did you lie about it then?
Well, Melvin didn't tell me you were going to be here.
I live upstairs.
Look, I have to show my mother inside, okay?
We'd find that our love is unaltered by time.
Thank you for taking me in. You won't be sorry.
I'm sorry already.
The night
seem to fade in a blossoming
You didn't say she was coming without a bed.
I'll buy her one, first chance I get.
Remember, I said she could stay here, but I didn't say I'd have anything to do with her.
Harvey, I'm making tea. You want tea? Harvey?
You stay there, I'll get it.
Where is Mel?
He's gone to work.
It's Saturday. Where is he?
He has something at the school with the students. Why do you want him?
Oh.
What did he do?
He's got no right to judge me. I'm not one of his students.
Yeah, Melvin always judges everybody. He says he doesn't, but he does.
Well, I don't have to take it.
He was born that way. When he came out, he had this sour expression on his face, like nobody in the delivery room was doing anything right.
Well, you have to take it. I don't.
Do as I do. Don't pay any attention. Why is he judging you?
He's been avoiding me since you saw me at the nightclub.
You're in a nightclub?
If I was talking to you, I'd tell you to shut up. When did I see you? I didn't see you.
You must have seen me.
I was drunk.
Well, he saw me.
So?
I was one of the dancers.
You take off your clothes?
Now, you're judging me.
Listen, you want to talk to me? Come outside.
Where are you going?
None of your business.
You and your son. Now you are both too good for me.
You're stupid.
Thank you.
You're welcome. You think I care if you take your clothes off? You're stupid because you think you're the boss of your life.
What?
You're not the boss, and I'm not the boss.
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about the baby, for God's sake. What's the matter with you? And I'm talking about my own life, too. You think I wouldn't like to pack it in?
Pack it in? What does that mean? Go on a trip?
Yeah, exactly, with a one-way ticket. Kill myself.
Goodbye, George.
You haven't seen the last of me. Just wait.
Tomorrow. Everything always happens tomorrow. What happened? Harvey?
The last thing I want is something to do with you. I was going to be nice for Melvin's sake, but I got no respect for you, Harvey.
Oh, you have no respect for me.
That's right. And you don't respect yourself either.
Don't be an idiot.
You're the idiot. And you're a coward as well. Melvin told me what you wanted to do.
What do you mean? No right to touch my things. Who the hell does he think he is anyway?
He thinks he's your son.
Look, just get out of here and close the door.
Don't worry, I'm going. Listen, big shot. I had a few good years with Jerry, so I got nothing to complain. But if you think I want something to do with you, you're even crazier than I thought. Believe you me, I'd rather watch television.
Thank
I just want you to know I don't lie to most people. Just you.
Oh, yeah? What about my father?
Because your mind is so skinny.
What about my mother?
They got divorced because she went bowling. You want me to tell them I'm a stripper? I don't mind being naked. Doesn't bother me. Colin, men don't care about clothes. Even with clothes, they see you naked. What do you think he's looking at?
What?
My body, that's what.
Tại sao bà chỉ cho tôi? Tôi có làm gì bậy bạ đâu.
Men are men. I don't care what goes on in their heads. Except the ones who think they are better than me.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute.
What do you want?
Suppose we stop thinking about ourselves for just 1 minute. I mean, just suppose we stop thinking about ourselves, okay?
What do you want?
Well, what if you decided that you wanted it, that you were interested in having it? Of course, I know it's still your decision.
Having what?
The baby, goddammit! Baby. I want to be involved.
Oh, I see. You're coming on your big white horse. Oh, wow. Now a man is here to look after me. Sweep me up on your horse. Take me to your kitchen. I'll tell you why I became a stripper. For the money. So I will never have to get stuck with someone like you.
Walter's here?
It's Melvin.
Melvin broke a table?
It's not funny. He's got plenty of trouble.
What kind of trouble?
All of a sudden, you're talking to me.
I'm not talking to you. I'm asking a question.
Ask all you want. You're talking to yourself.
I'm talking to you.
Stop it! I thought we could all live together. I forgot how pig-headed you both are.
What's going on? Come on, Rose. Huh? What kind of trouble? Jackie? What is there between him and Jackie? Come on, he goes out with a girl named Marilyn.
It's her. What he sees in her, I don't know.
What do you mean? What's wrong with Jackie?
Nothing's wrong with her. She just takes her clothes off, that's all.
I'm not that judge. So who does it hurt if she takes off her clothes herself, maybe? That's all.
And another little thing. She's not Jewish.
Who said she's not Jewish?
Harvey, she's not Jewish.
By religion, she's not Jewish, but she has a Jewish character. Jackie, how could that be so dumb?
For you, it comes natural.
How can you do this when you don't agree with me?
I'm your friend, whether or not we agree.
I'm glad you offered to come. I couldn't ask Walter.
I'm sure Melvin would help you. How long does it take?
Not long, but I must stay for a while to be sure I'm all right. You can hold my hand?
I don't mind holding your hand.
You are my friend, Harvey.
The only thing I don't understand is what's the big hurry? Maybe you'll change your mind. Maybe you should wait a few days, and then if you want to go, I'll come with you again. All right. I didn't say nothing. But don't drive so fast. You're making me dizzy.
Harvey? Harvey? Harvey, what happened? Harvey, oh my God.
But if that was defensive behavior, does that mean Freud was right? Sir? Sir?
What's that got to do with abortion?
I didn't say anything about abortion, sir. We weren't talking about abortion.
You want to talk about it? All right, let's talk about it. I suppose you've all got strong feelings on the subject. Probably intolerant of anyone who disagrees. We all like to fight. No respect at all for valid concerns on the other side. All right. I believe that life begins at conception. That means that abortion at any time during the pregnancy involves the taking of life. But I also believe that a woman has to have control of her own reproductive system. I mean, who the hell is going to tell her what to do? She's been around a lot longer than the fetus. What about the Walter factor? I mean, what about somebody who's emotionally involved but not technically involved? What the hell is he supposed to do, right? Supposed to just mind his own business, right? Supposed to just walk around in circles talking about Freud.
I don't understand it. Your heart is completely normal.
Listen, so long I'm okay and all right, we don't have to worry about it. Why don't I just rest here a little while, then I'll go home.
Okay, get dressed.
Be careful.
It's okay, I'm fine. Thank you very much.
Harvey, I'm so relieved. Are you all right? What did they say?
It's nothing. They just called it a little warning. I'll be fine in just a little while. But listen, we better go to the clinic. We'll be late.
I missed my appointment. I'll have to make a new one.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Never mind. I'm happy you're all right.
Pa?
What do you want?
I want to talk to you about Jackie. You and Ma.
Later. Ma? Did you hear Ma go out? Huh? Why'd you lock the door? Pa? Pa, you all right? Pa, what are you doing in there? Pa, if you don't open the door, I'm gonna break it down. What's the excitement?
Well, don't play games with me. I know about those pills that you saved up.
They'll be so dramatic.
Is mine there?
Melvin, I think tonight maybe you should sleep in your own bed.
I hope you know what you're doing.
Come on, if I didn't know what I was doing, you wouldn't be here.
Yeah, okay, don't joke about it. You know, you just take these things too lightly instead of making sure you're really serious about each other.
Come on, we used to be married. What did you want to talk about?
Nothing.
Do you have electricity?
I'm glad you're here.
There's only one box and it's down here. The alarm didn't go off and I missed my appointment again. Is Harvey asleep?
Yes, he is.
Tell him thanks and a ways for the plaque. Where is your mother?
Oh, she's asleep too. I thought we were gonna check electricity.
I want to talk to you about my father.
Some of these fuses are loose.
He's very depressed, you know, at least I thought he was depressed.
How come these fuses are loose?
You know, he feels his life has no continuity. At least he did feel that way. And you want to sing, right? And these old houses are made for families, you know?
What are you talking about?
Get out of bed. I want to talk to you. I mean it.
We're not in bed. What's the matter, dear? Why are you getting so upset?
Thanks for rushing things.
You forgot your cane in the utility room.
What are you talking about?
What's going on?
This explains the phony heart attack. I talked to the doctor at the clinic.
Why? Why would you do this to me?
What did he do to you?
Nothing. I didn't do nothing to nobody.
What's the matter?
I'm pregnant.
Harvey made you pregnant? I heard of miracles, but that's too much.
What's so terrible? I stopped you from doing something you regret.
It's not your decision to make.
Wait a minute. Melvin is the one who made you pregnant?
No.
Who's left?
Walter.
Who's Walter?
I can't believe you would do that.
So what did I do? Did I commit murder?
I still don't know what he did.
Who do you think you are? Is it your life you're talking about? You think it's easy to give up a chance for a baby? I'm frightened. I never had an operation before. The longer I wait, the more dangerous it gets. Did you think about that?
Please, I feel terrible. I'll go crazy sitting in that house.
Mel is coming with me.
So I'll come too. If they don't let me in, I'll wait in the car. No tricks, I promise. I'm stupid, but at least I'll learn from my mistakes.
All right.
Wait a minute. So long I'll be waiting in the car. Do you mind if Rose keeps me company?
Oh, no.
Whoa!
Oh, for God's sake.
What do you think we're going to? A picnic?
She's right. I'm sorry, dear. I'll go back.
Maybe I should stay, too. Melvin, you'll phone me up from the clinic. Tell me how things are going. Pass me my chair.
No. I'm sorry. I'm just nervous. I want you to come. Really. You too. But hurry. We're late.
Jackie, we're here. Look. Look, I'll be right there with you, all right? As close as they let me.
You said yourself it doesn't take long. You'll be fine, you'll see.
Maybe I should go in with you. Maybe she needs another woman.
I keep going in circles. I can't have a baby now, but if I don't have a baby now, when can I have a baby?
And if I do have a baby now, what do I know about babies? And if I don't have a baby now...
Maybe you should...
Oh, Colin, not a word, Harvey. This is my decision.
Pa, don't mix in.
Shut up, Harvey.
My heart is beating too fast. Do you mind driving?
Here I go again. I hear those trumpets blow again. Chance on love. Well, here I slide again, about to take that ride again, starry eyed again, taking a chance on love.
Oh!
Why are you yelling? It doesn't hurt.
You, it doesn't hurt. There. You happy? You made me yell. We woke up the baby.
You woke the baby.
Well, don't just stand there. Go get
her. She's supposed to be sleeping now.
Supposed to. Who does what they're supposed to do? Go get her.
There. She stopped crying. So let's be quiet.
Go get her.
You ought to be ashamed of yourself waking her up just so you can play with her.
Shut up. Go get her.
I'm feeling grand again, taking a chance on love. I never dreamed in my slumbers, and that's what taboo. Now I'm playing the numbers, and a little dream for two. I'm wading in again, I'm leading with my chin again. I'm starting out to win again, taking a chance on give